Hello and welcome. This first lecture is a brief introduction to algebra, and we will be learning some of the terminology or terms used in algebra. And these are the words which you will be listening again and again in this course. So the first thing is algebraic expression. As you already know, the arithmetic expression is a statement in which we have numbers and operators, few of the numbers and few of the operators. For example, 5 multiplied by 2 plus 3 minus 4 is an arithmetic expression. We have some numbers and we have some operators. There is a multiplication operator, an addition operator, and a subtraction operator. And there are 4 numbers. So this is a statement which has numbers and operators. So if I replace any of these numbers, at least one of them, with any letter, then this arithmetic expression will become an algebraic expression. For example, this 5, I replace this 5 with a letter X, multiplied by 2. And remember, in algebra we almost always do not put a multiplication sign. We don't put anything. Sometimes we can put dot just to elaborate a little bit, but we don't put anything. So X multiplied by 2, we write it as 2x in algebra. So 2x plus 3 minus 4. This is now an algebraic expression. So we always put a number first and then the letter. We have replaced one number with a letter, but this is still a combination of number and a letter. 2x, 2 is a number, x is a letter. So first of all, what is this x? This x in algebra, not only x, but any letter. X, Y, we use many letters in algebra. X, Y, A, B, mostly we use lowercase letters, but you can use capital letters, doesn't make any difference. So we use letters in algebra, and this is the main difference between arithmetic and algebra. So these letters stands for numbers. As in this case, this X stands for a number 5. We know this number. But sometimes we don't know this number. If I have a algebraic expression 5x minus 7, I don't know what is x. And I cannot find x only from an expression until this expression becomes an equation. And how it becomes an equation? If I put an equal sign, any statement which has an equal sign becomes an equation. For example, if I write like this, 5x minus 7 equals 0, then this expression will become an equation. So equation has expression on both sides. And the left hand side must be equal to the right hand side. So what we are saying here is that if I multiply an unknown number x with 5 and subtract 7 from that product, I will get 0. So what is the value of x? We don't know yet, but we can find. There are algebraic procedures and methods to solve these type of algebraic equations, and we will be doing this later in this course. But the purpose of this first lecture is to get you familiar with some of the words, some of the terms, as in English, terms which we will be commonly using during this course. So now we talk about what is an algebraic term. So algebraic term has 3 components. It has a letter, it has a number, a sign number which could be positive or negative, and it has an exponent. So an algebraic term can have this form minus 2x raised to the power 3. So in this, these are few of the components of an algebraic term. So what is this x? As I already mentioned, this x is an unknown number, but there is also a name for this, which is called base, because it has an exponent and it has a coefficient. So an algebraic term has a form with the coefficient. If I represent this coefficient with another letter, so I can say that A is a coefficient, X is a variable, and N is an exponent. So I can say that an algebraic term has a form of Ax raised to the power N, where A is a number, X is a number, and N could be a number. So when we write something like this, we say algebraic term has a form Ax raised to the power N. When we write anything in this form, so what we are doing is we are trying to generalize the things. So this is generality. We are trying to generalize the things. And this is the way we solve problems in algebra. We try to generalize things and then try to achieve an abstract solution, a more general solution to a problem. So this we will explain in depth later in this course, but at this time these are few of the things which I wanted to highlight in this first section of introduction. What is an algebraic expression? What is an algebraic equation? And what is an algebraic term? This is also an algebraic term, but the base here is xy. Xy is the base of this algebraic term. Similarly, take another algebraic term, 3x raised to the power 2yz. So this is also an algebraic term. So what about whether these terms can be added or subtracted or multiplied or not? Like numbers, we can multiply any number. But what about these terms? When we use these terms in a statement or in an expression or in an equation, so can we do operation on these terms or not? Can I add minus 2x cube to 5xy? What would be the result? Can I add these three terms? Can I multiply these three terms? Can I simplify these three terms? So these are the different type of questions which we will be answering in our next videos.